In this section, we're going to build out our user interface for parameter controls. So we'll open up our parameter control screen and go to our toolbox. And under controls, we have the parameter set control. So I'm just going to select it and just put it out on the screen. And we'll go to the properties. And under fixed parameter set, we're just going to go choose our PS color parameter set type. And this control will allow us to put in entries for the color parameter set. Next, we want to add tags for each element of the parameter set so that we can show how to upload and download recipes. So if we go look at our tags, because it's a UDT, we've got these data elements, and we need to create an IO field and a label for each of these. So I'm going to leave that as a challenge. What I would like you to do is on your parameter control, just put IO fields and labels for each of the parameter set type elements. And when you come back, I'll show you how I did it. So with a color UDT, there's no way to really drop a UDT tag on the screen and get it to populate all of the elements. So we'll add these manually. We'll go to elements and we'll add an IO field. And then under basic objects, we'll add a label. And for our label, the first element is color name. And on the IO field, under process value, we'll do the drop down under dynamization and choose tag. We'll go to our color tags table and expand it. And here's the elements of our UDT, and we'll just assign color name. And then we're just going to copy these and assign the rest of the elements. So I use Control C, Control V. And then we'll go ahead and fill out each of these. This will be our red component. Blue. And this will be color out. And then we assign our tags. So there's red. And color out. And we'll just hit save. So now let's go to runtime and see how we can get some records into our color parameter control. So we'll go to our parameter control page, and you can see right now there's no elements available. It shows our structure. So we're going to go down and hit the new record button. So this parameter set is going to signify a color record. So let's just call this one red, and we can start at number one. And so you can just fill in the values. And so we're dealing with color 0 to 255. So red would be 255, green and blue out would be 0. But what about color out? Well, we'll get to that in a minute. Let's give it a name and call this red as well and save it. And then let's create another one, call it blue. We'll make it number 2. And then for the color blue, it's going to be all blue and no red or green. And we'll call it blue. Make sure you save it. And then we'll create another record for green. Make it number 3. And we'll do the same thing here, 255, and call it green. And save it. And so now we've got 3 recipes, if you will, or sets of parameters, and we can look and see these in this control. The UDT tags would ideally exist under address spaces in your PLC, and this is how you communicate and tell the process that you want to use this color. And this is two-way communication. So if we want to download to the PLC, we can pick a parameter set. So we'll pick red and hit download. And you can see it fills in the tags with the information from this record. If I go to blue and do a download, you can see it changes to blue and green. But what about color out? That is going to be the RGB value of these three components. And so we're going to need to know how to get that. If you remember from the JavaScripting section of this course, we use the RGB function. So our next exercise is going to be writing a script that will calculate what RGB should be and show it as a number and a color, and we'll update the records for the appropriate color out values. So we'll go back to TIA portal and we'll put a button on the screen, and for the text I'm just going to put calculate RGB. And so here's a challenge for you. When this button is pressed, you need to get the red, green, and blue components of whichever parameter control record is downloaded, calculate the RGB, and put it into the color out tag. So go ahead, pause the video and complete the challenge, and when you come back, I'll show you how I did it. Okay, so let's go to events on our button, and we'll go straight to our JavaScript property. And first we need to read the tags. So we'll get a reference to the value of the red tag. We'll do let red equal, we'll do our tags object. And remember, we can hit Control J to get our browser. And we'll call our read method. And then we'll do the same for the other colors. So now we'll create a reference to our color out tag. But I'm not going to do a read method on it because we're actually going to be writing to it. And so color out is a reference to the tag. And then we can just say color out dot write, and then the value is going to go in here. And if you recall, go to HMI Runtime, Math, RGB, and then we can just add our color variables. And that should write in the calculated RGB value into the color out tag. So let's test it out in Runtime. We've got green downloaded. We can just hit calculate RGB, and we do get some kind of number here. And then let's select red and then download that, and we do get a number. How do we know that the number is the right color? We should be able to take that value and put it into the background colors property of an object and see if it's the right color. So let's go do that. So I'll just add a circle. And let's give it a name. Let's just say circle color out. And we can just assign a tag. And we'll just put that as color out. So let's see if that works. So we'll go to parameter control. And it looks like red's selected, so it looks like it's working. Let's go to blue, download that. And we haven't done the calculate RGB, so we do that. And what we have to do is upload these values, especially the color out value. So right now blue is loaded and we've updated our color out value. So now we use the upload, that's going away from the PLC. We'll just overwrite the parameter set. And so it's saved that color. And then we'll go to red, color out hasn't been saved there. So first we'll download it, we'll hit calculate, and then we'll hit upload. And we're just gonna overwrite that one. And then finally, we'll do the same thing to green. We'll download it, calculate the RGB value, and then upload that back into our set. So what we have now is just a set of three colors, and we used a script to calculate what the output color should be, and then we've created a UI to kind of test it. So as we load these, it updates our tags. Now that we have the basic parameter control demo working, I want to add some elements to the user interface to make it easier to add new color records to our parameter controls. So let's go back to the TIA software. I'm going to move our IO fields and labels over. And then under elements on the toolbox, I'm going to add three sliders, one for each color. And so I have a new challenge for you. So in this challenge, I want you to take the calcRGB code that is on the button and convert it into a global function on the screen's event context. You could also make it a global function in the project if you wish. And then add three slider components, one for each color in our UDT, and assign the appropriate UDT color tags. Make sure to set the max value on each slider to 255. And finally, when a slider value changes, use the change event to call your new calcRGB function so that the color out tag changes. So go ahead and pause the video, complete the assignment, and when you come back, I'll show you how I did it. Okay, the first thing I want to do is I want to convert the script on this button to a global function because we're going to need to use it on our sliders. So I'm just going to copy the code here and delete it. And then on the global definitions area, we will do export function get RGB. We don't really need to pass any parameters because our script grabs what we need directly from the tags. And then I'll just copy this and go back to the function space on the button, and I can just make that call. Then on each slider, we'll go set up the appropriate tags. So under process value, we're going to set that to a tag, and then we'll go set that up for red. And then if you expand process value on the change event, we'll add a script there, and we're going to add the same function call. So there's one other thing I want to change here, this normal range color. I'm just going to set it to the color of the component. And then we'll repeat that for the other two sliders. So for our process value, set our tag. And this is going to be green. Make sure I get the semicolon in there. And then we'll set our normal range to kind of the normal green. And finally, we'll do blue. Add our function call. And set our normal range color. Now, one other thing really important that we have to do is we have to set our max range, maximum scale value. And that's got to be 255. If we don't do that, then the color is not going to be right when we change it. So we'll set it on our green. and we've got it set on our red. So now we'll go check it out in runtime. Okay, so back in runtime, we'll go to parameter control and we'll move the sliders, and we'll see that it is updating our color out tag, which is in turn updating our circle. Now we can save this color as a new record in our parameter control set. So we'll just give it a name, call it pink, and then we'll hit the upload from process button and create a new parameter set and hit read. So it reads in from the PLC and now we have a new record. So we can download blue, we can download our new pink. So we can create a couple more here if we want. So let's call this one cyan. Upload. And maybe one more. We'll call this magenta. Okay, so now we've got kind of a nice interface to create new colors and add them to our parameter control set library.